What is up, YouTube? I'm Devon DaVinci, leader of the Renaissance crew, and you are watching DaVinci Reacts, or DaVinci Watch. Again, it really depends on what the name of the video is. If it says watch, that means the video has been edited in some way, either the audio has been removed or altered, the video is blurred or something in order to get it around any type of copyright issues that it may get through YouTube. If it says reacts, then that means that it's just a regular video. There's been no changes to the original video. Sometimes if I do reactions to music, there might be like jump cuts, but that's it. So if you're watching the DaVinci Watch version of the video, there are obviously instructions for what you have to do in order to get the full experience. The best way that you can do this without, if you don't have a VPN, if you have a VPN, switch to a United States server. Usually that will work and you'll be able to see the DaVinci React version of the video. But if you're just looking at the DaVinci Watch and there's no other alternatives, right click on the original link in the description box down below. Click open on new window. Once a new window pops up, shrink the video down, or shrink the original video window or whatever down so that it's in the corner of this video. And play the my video. Once I say go on my video, it's a signal to click the play button on the original. Click the play button and everything should be synced up. There will be a preview in my video that will show you what I'm currently watching. So if your video is not synced up with that, then that means that you're off at some point. So you might want to adjust it so that everything is working together. Now, with that being said, just a quick announcement. I am back. I am live streaming on Twitch again. I'm currently streaming Final Fantasy VII Remake. If coming over and watching me live stream and joining the chat is something that interests you, there's a link for my Twitch channel in the description box down below. I will be streaming again today at 3 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, probably around 3 to 4 hour stream. So if you want to join me anytime during that point, just jump in and I'll be sure to welcome you. And I will be streaming every day this week, or at least every weekday this week at 6, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, whichever one happens to, as long as the video is healthy by the end of that 3 hour point, I might go to 4 hours, but 3 hours is my plan. Now with that, that's enough of that. Let's jump straight into this. This is The Inbetweeners season 2, episode 4, A Night in London. Hopefully everything will be fixed. I tried, fixing some stuff around. It shouldn't be lagging as much, at least I hope. Let's go ahead and check this out and see what it has to offer. So remember, countdown, then go, click the play button. 3, 2, 1, go. Friend.
In case you're interested, at my old school, the day began with prayers, followed by hymns, and then an inspirational reading. Here it began with Jay showing me a pornographic video.
Right. Watch this. This is tame, they're not even naked.
I know that music.
Oh, wait,
I know that music.
Oh, God.
No, no.
That can't be real.
Don't do it.
That's gotta be chocolate. I should have got a bigger cup. How tame is that then?
They're watching the
Christ,
video.
I'm gonna hate. Jesus wept. Don't lick it! She's gonna vomit. I'm gonna vomit. This is the best bit, look. Oh!
That was the original reaction
it's
video.
To unsee things. I don't like girls anymore.
Oh, man.
So you get a new laptop, the first thing you did was find that. No.
That video is probably older than YouTube.
This was the first thing.
Oh, yeah. Oh my God.
Okay.
Oh, shit. You lot are such saddos.
That's it. We can't carry on like this.
Carry on like what?
We can't spend another term treading water, being the same old sad case.
Somebody already commented what shadows was, so.
You just got caught in a sad case. Look, we've got to do something.
What do you mean?
Carpe diem.
Go fishing.
Seize the day. Do something unexpected. Reinvent ourselves. Show the girls and everyone else who we really are.
Reinvent ourselves as what?
I don't know. Literally anything. Something cool. We could start going clubbing in London.
My dad would never let me drive to London.
Thanks, Si, that's the spirit.
I could drive us. I got a car last weekend.
You've got a car? You haven't even passed your test yet.
Yeah, I have.
And you never thought to mention it?
You never asked.
Oh, of course.
Okay.
I forgot that's the way it works. We have to ask you every single thing that might have happened in case it did.
This is brilliant, Neil. Now we don't have to drive around in Simon's little bitchmobile.
All right, no more lists
for you then.
You
haven't seen the car yet. Don't judge just yet.
If you don't have to drive where you come.
It's not the driving I'm worried about. It's more that we won't get in anywhere, won't get served, and might get robbed, stabbed,
or
killed.
Fake ID.
Bullshit. Right? I go out to London all the time.
When do you ever go to London?
All the time. I went last weekend. I fucked some girl up there.
Did you? Where was that then?
It was in the Tower of London.
The Tower of London? What did you do after you fucked her? Cut her head off? Showed her the crown jewels?
She'd already seen the crown jewels, thanks. My bell end.
Of course.
Brilliant. Reinventing ourselves as clubbers was a brilliant idea of mine. Obviously, we wouldn't actually get in anywhere, but Simon could at least give it a go.
Come on, Si, please come along.
But it'll be expensive, won't it? Don't some of those clubs charge 30 quid to get in?
I've already told you, I know the bloke who runs all the doors. It'll just slip us in.
And when that turns out to be bullshit, what then?
Hi, Simon.
Carly!
How's your stomach?
Carly!
Oh, fine.
Simon had really bad diarrhoea of the weekend.
Ooh.
Really bad.
Look,
now something you
we're
going
up to London
for.
On Saturday. Clubbing. Do you want to come?
Sounds fun, we'd love to go. Which club are you going to?
Why do those lockers look drawn on?
Spearmint Rhino.
Isn't that a strip club?
No, he's made a mistake. We're going to one of the big ones. One of the big, cool ones right in the middle of London.
All right, which one?
The land of...
The sound of...
We usually go to the Astoria.
And that's exactly where we're going.
Cool.
And I'm driving if you want a lift.
No, we're cool. We'll probably head up early, check out the shops. A lift back would be great, though.
No problemo.
So do you go clubbing a lot, then?
Me?
Yeah, you.
Yeah.
Relax,
yeah,
Will. Of course. Relax.
Dancing on the podium, probably. Or up by the speakers, where it's, if anything, too loud.
Relax.
Great, see you there. See
the girl appears to be interested in you. Relax.
What did I tell you? London and Muff go hand in hand.
Fucking hell, I'm going on a date with Carly.
It's not really a date.
I think it is.
I reckon you're in there too.
Me? Why do you think that?
Because she touched her ear. In body language speak, that means she wants you.
Well, in London on Saturday night, there'll be plenty of girls around me touching their hair.
Their pubic hair, presumably?
No. They're long.
They're
pubic hair.
Yeah, can't even do it.
Saturday rolled around, and we were all incredibly excited about our night out in London. Rachel, an actual girl with a working face, had asked me if I was going. Simon got to continue his stalking of Carly. Neil just liked being out in the open, like a Labrador. And Jay was up for some more make-believe sex in a tourist attraction. Maybe a handjob at Mandatory Swords. Of course, I had no idea how we'd actually get into a club, but I wasn't taking any chances and wore my smartest shoes. Something Simon didn't do.
Shoes. Why are you wearing trainers, Si?
Because they look good.
I specifically said no trainers.
Not if you
I know what
into
trainers
clubs.
Are.
Everyone wears trainers.
They're regular sneakers, tennis shoes.
Well, I haven't got trainers on.
I've researched
flippers on. What size are they? Size 8. My size.
Oh, yeah, Ronald McDonald called. He wants his shoes back.
There's nothing wrong
That's
with
what
these.
I'm saying. They're duck shoes.
Hey, where are my flippers?
At least you'd be all right if you fall in the Thames.
Yeah, very funny. Would it have killed you to wear shoes just to be on the safe side?
Whoa, check out Neil's car.
Yeah, shit hot.
I'd say half right. It's shit.
But a rubbish red nose wasn't the main attraction.
Don't even got a car. He's a hater.
Hi, Kate.
What the heck?
He's upstairs.
What the hell?
So how's things with you?
Yeah, I feel like I haven't seen you in ages.
Neil, your friends want to know if
God
you're coming
damn.
Out to play.
Come in.
So, Katie, do you like clubbing?
Can you stop staring at my tits, please?
She must be on the blob.
All right. What do you think of the car, then?
It's like a tractor beam for Fanny.
I love it.
It's got a Piper exhaust and a well-smart body kit. My sister's
play a drinking game.
Do it up. He's a mechanic.
Must be nice for your dad to have a man about the house, Neil.
What does that mean?
It means, does your dad suck him off?
No.
Damn.
But your sister does.
No. Well, I mean, she might do.
Oh, she definitely does.
Play a drinking game for every
nice
time.
Porsche engineering sticker.
Jay uses a pseudonym for.
It's got to be worth at least a hand job.
Fanny.
So how fast is it going?
Who knows? I ain't got it going yet.
What? This will be the first time you've driven it.
No, it don't work. It ain't got an engine. Dave's still trying to find me one.
But I thought you were driving us up to London.
Yeah, so did I.
So how do you plan to drive us up there without a car?
I thought I was going to drive your car.
But you're not insured to drive my car, Neil.
Yeah, I wondered about that.
Oh well, Simon, you're going to have to drive us.
No, I said no. And my dad will go mental if he finds out I've driven to London.
He won't find out.
And even if he does, you'll have far too many fingers up Carly to care.
Please, Simon.
I came out of nowhere.
Oh, Christ, thanks a lot, Neil.
You need to be clearer about things, I reckon.
It's
okay,
Jay, so.
Is this clear enough?
You're a fucking idiot.
Kind of.
Calm down. I'll get some beers for the trip.
I can't drink and drive.
Of course you can. It's just the same.
So Jay liberated a few of his dad's lagers and we were off. The plan was simple. Get to London, get into a club, pull Carly and Rachel, and then return to school on Monday morning to find our credibility at an all-time high. Yes, as it was simple, not realistic. In the meantime, we can enjoy the enlightening conversation.
Yeah, who would you rather fuck? Will's mum or Neil's sister?
Oh, good.
Well, leave it out. Will's mum.
Don't join in, Neil.
Neil's sister would have the tightest snatch, I guess.
Leave it out.
But Will's mum has got huge tits.
They are amazing.
Thanks. Although Neil's sister looks like she'd be better at sucking dick.
Like father, like daughter.
Oh, yeah. I could see her going at it like a dog eating my chips.
Shut up, Jay.
I'd like to put my cock in them both.
That's a touching sentiment.
I'd be touching your mum's sentiment.
That doesn't mean anything.
It means I'd touch her bum hole. With my cock.
Nice one.
Oh boy.
I thought about it and I'd definitely rather fuck Will's mum.
Are you sure, Neil? What about your sister's tight snatch?
No, totally sure.
Well, that's good then.
I've thought about it.
Slow down a minute, sorry.
Wasn't for me.
Bus wankers!
Where did that come
from? I believe Jay is what TLC would call a scrub.
I don't know, it just felt right.
You could see their little faces drop as they thought, we must be the bus wankers.
Pull over, Si, I need a piss.
Oh, I can't pull over, there's a bus lane.
Oh, please, I'm desperate, mate.
You just have to hold it, Neil. We're late enough.
Okay,
Are you pissing in my car?
No.
What's that noise, then?
I'm pissing in a can.
What the fuck? You'll get piss on the floor.
Don't worry, it won't overflow. I've got my chapsire right in there, so I can't miss. No problemo.
It stinks, Neil.
Uh-oh. It don't want to stop.
What do you mean, it?
Just stop pissing yourself, Neil.
Quick, pass me another can.
That's not happening.
Quick, it's filled up to the top. I'll get it out.
Oh, shit!
Oh, my helmet! I've cut it on the can. Oh, I think it's bleeding.
Fuck bleeding? Is it still pissing?
Oh, it stings.
Does anybody want to swap seats?
I will.
Not you, Neil.
Get rid of it, Neil.
Oh, Neil. So high on the smell of Neil's urine, we headed for the bright lights of London.
See, normally in
look out, ladies, phase one
the UK,
was
they will bass over littering like that. I saw a video. You guys take littering seriously.
And we even managed to see all the sights. Because Simon got us totally fucking lost.
It must be somewhere around here. I knew we'd get lost. Thanks a lot, Neil.
Is it my fault you're a shit driver?
I don't want Carly to be pissed off if I'm late.
You need to grow some balls, I reckon. Look, why don't we just pull over and ask someone where the club full of clunge is?
Oh, I've got Google Maps on my phone. Should be able to find it, no problemo.
Neil, you have to stop.
Aye.
No, Jay.
Go on. Bus wankers. Why are you slowing down?
I tried to say.
Oh, Christ, Jay.
Oh, shit.
Oh, no, they're coming. Shit, drive.
Where? Where am I meant to drive to? Anywhere.
Oh, shit. Oh. Anywhere but the pavement.
Perfect. Oh.
Listen, mate. Sorry. I'm sorry. I'm
you
really
just
sorry.
Choked
I'm really
his
sorry. I'm sorry. I'm a wanker, mate. I'm really sorry. I'm sorry.
Yeah?
Sorry. I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. I'm sorry.
Sorry. I'm a wanker,
man,
yeah?
I'm really sorry.
He's
I'm
really sorry.
Oh, man.
I'm sorry.
Why is he like John Jones?
Sorry.
I'd rather be a bus wanker than drive that piece of yellow.
Oh, man.
Fucking hell, you two shit yourselves.
What?
Oh, sorry.
I guess
sorry.
I lost some
oh,
points.
Sorry, don't hurt me. Sorry.
You got me fucking throttled.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, fuck off.
Sorry, I'm on the pavement.
Oh, sorry, sorry. Sorry for my little shit car.
I'm sorry that I'm alive and a bender.
Just fuck off. Sorry, Si.
Oh, man.
Sorry, I'm such a tear.
Oh, sorry, I've done a poo in my pants.
Oh,
oh
my
sorry,
God.
My neck is stuck in your hand.
Simon's a good friend, but it's fair to say he drives like a retard.
That was
but eventually, in Chinatown, just a few hundred yards from the club, we found the perfect parking space. Well, almost perfect.
I don't think I can park here.
Simon, we've been driving around for an hour looking for a parking space. This one's perfect. Let's just get going.
But it says we'll get clamped.
Nah, it's a weekend, isn't it? It's different rules.
I'm sure he's right, Si. And no one clamps anymore. Please, can we get going? I really need to check my
face
notes.
Hurts.
I think I've got a big problemo.
Can you stop saying problemo?
What?
It's not cool or funny. It's just embarrassing.
Don't worry, Neil. He'll say sorry in a minute.
Maybe I should move it. Simon, listen to me.
Carly has agreed to go clubbing with you. That is a big step forward. Mm-hmm. But in the hour it would take for us to find another parking space, she could have got off the idea.
Yeah, she could be wanking off the DJ by now.
I doubt that's happening. But the point is valid. This is a great parking spot. Let's just get a move on.
We are wasting valuable boning time.
Fine, fine. Come on, then.
I don't bother locking it, Si. If you're lucky, someone might nick it.
Yeah, good one.
So despite the odd throttling and cut penis, we made it to the club safely. And the girls even seemed pleased to see us.
Carly.
Oh, hi, Simon. Wondered where you were.
Did you? You're actually here.
Yes.
You weren't lying about coming then?
No. Why would I be lying?
Here.
Don't know. Don't know why I said that.
Yeah, that was
great. Well, we'll
redundant.
See you in there then.
Don't be a tit. Just stand here.
Oh, are you joining us?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think so. Oh.
Are you fucking pushing in? Those arseholes pushed in.
So, great you're near the front.
Yeah, well, yeah. I've been here long enough.
I suppose you have.
Oh, I just really want to get inside and dance now.
Yeah, me too. There's something very animalistic about our need to dance, isn't there?
I think those lads are throwing stuff at you.
Don't think so. They're probably just frustrated because they want to get inside too. They're saying, let us in! We've got bloody great dancing ants in our pants!
Get to the back of the queue, you four-eyed prick!
Sorry, do you mind if I stand with my back to you? I just don't want them to think that you're with me.
No, that's fine.
That.
Rachel had the most beautiful back of a head I'd ever seen. Now all we had to do was get into the club.
That hurts.
No trainers.
What?
No trainers.
But they're new.
No trainers.
I'll see you in there in a minute.
Well, that's us fucked in.
I'll take it you don't know that bouncer then, Jay.
What's this got to do with me? I'm not the one wearing trainers.
You fucking idiot. I'm totally in there. Like, totally.
See, if they were Jordans, you'd be in.
Probably make another pair out of yours. I'd have enough leather left to cover a sofa.
Doesn't matter anyway, because I've sorted it. I'm going to borrow some shoes.
What?
Come on, then, shut!
Oh, no. Look, I'm going to level with you. I am scared. London scares me. The bouncer scares me, and that man really scares me. Let's just put this one down as another character-forming experience and go home.
Oh, come on, Will, it's for Carly. She'll love it. It's romantic.
It's not quite Romeo and Juliet, is it?
More stalkerish.
These tramp shoes we're talking about. Excuse me, mate. Mate, excuse me.
Very stalker.
Can I borrow your shoes? I want to borrow your shoes? I'm trying to impress a girl.
Give us a blowjob.
What?
I'll give you a blowjob.
No, got it. No, no blowjobs. I just want your shoes.
All right. 20 quid.
Great.
And your shoes.
Oh, of course.
Good old Simon. I could always rely on him to add a touch of class to proceedings. In many ways, though, it proved how much he valued Carly.
Funky as hell.
Certainly more than he valued his dignity.
They're a bit wet.
Aye. That'll be my piss.
Okay. Thanks.
I'm not saying it was a dodgy club, but you have to question a door policy which says no to trainers, but a big thumbs up to piss-soaked tramp shoes.
Wow.
But we were in. We had got in. Yes, in the club. An actual club. Yes!
I've died and gone to Clunge Heaven.
Oh, nice.
Well, this is what we wanted. This is it. The first day of the rest of our lives.
It's one small step for a man, one giant leap for your flippers.
You won't be laughing when we pull Carly and Rachel.
No, I won't, because it ain't going to happen. All right, you can spend your evening talking to little girls. Me and Neil are going to find ourselves some proper
ironic,
women with experience snatches.
Good luck with that. Just so you know, I think the Tower of London is closed now.
That was a good comeback, Will.
Right, there she is. How do I look? You look good. From the ankles up, obviously. Obviously. Where's Rachel? Don't worry, she's keen. I'm sure she'll find me. Away you go, mate. Wish me luck.
I wonder if every time he walks, he goes...
Simon, you got in. I thought you were turned away.
Oh, well, Will was being a bit of a dick with the bouncers, and there was a thing with my shoes.
They're out of ice already. Can you believe that?
Oh, Simon, this is Adam. He's a mate of Rachel's.
Oh, all right.
Yeah, you?
Simon is an old friend of the family.
Not just that, though.
Can you smell piss?
Yes, that's totally rank.
Must be the toilets, we should move.
Yeah, good idea.
Meanwhile, Jay and Neil headed downstairs to discuss the nuances of sexual politics.
Oh, boy. She'll
definitely get it.
Most definitely.
What about her? I think she looked over.
Nice body. Frightening face. You'd have to do her from behind.
And what about her?
Bit big, but then fat girls are more grateful.
Oh, check out her jubblies on that.
Oh, she'd get it. Until it fell off.
Oh, please don't.
Please do.
Oh, no. She's giving me a boner and my cut's hurting worse than ever. I've got to go and check it out.
All right, but I might not be here when you get back, because that one's giving me the old I'm going to milk your balls dry look.
Also, I realize this is a Luther Vandross song. This singer isn't doing the song justice.
And in the toilets, Neil had a very big problemo with his cock.
He's being like, oh, man.
I had my own difficulties in the cock department. Rachel was sitting next to one.
Rachel! There you are. Found you.
Oh, boy.
Ready to put on your dancing shoes?
I know I am.
That's good.
Hi, I'm Will.
Dean.
So, do you come here often, Dean?
I bet you say that to all the girls.
He's got some chutzpah, I'll give him that. Anyway, nice to meet you, Dean, but we're off.
What? I'm good here, thanks.
Come on, Rachel.
Will.
It's getting a bit crowded around here. Hey, Dean?
I'm sorry, mate.
Look, come on, mate. You've had a good run.
Will, stop
Even
pretending
if I was in
you own the damn
girl. I saw a gorgeous
girl
sitting on her own. I'd have made the move, but I'm here now, so...
So what?
So, do the honourable thing and step aside. Because I was in with her first.
No, you weren't.
Is this guy for real? He talks like he's from a black and white film.
Yes, I was. I stood with you in the queue.
Behind me.
Well, I'm all beside you. And you specifically asked me if I was coming along tonight.
Oh, boy.
Like, I've got witnesses.
Oh,
well,
boy.
I think you've got the wrong end of the stick.
Evidently. So is that it? Shall I just go away?
Damn,
and leave
Will.
You to it?
Yes. Go away.
Oh,
fine.
Boy.
Fine. That's the last you see of me. Thanks, Dean. Thanks a lot, mate.
I was starting to go off Rachel. She wasn't really my type.
Why did you turn into
Elsewhere,
a character?
My friends were faring no better.
I can still smell it.
It's following us.
Simon, I'm not being rude, but I think that smell might be you.
Right. These shoes do kick up a bit.
Jesus, what the fuck is on your feet?
Oh, no, these aren't my shoes. I had to borrow them to get in.
Who brings spare shoes to a nightclub?
No one. I swapped them with a bloke outside the club.
What was he, a tramp?
Yeah.
I think you're supposed to say homeless now.
Sorry, you're wearing a tramp's shoes.
I think you're supposed to say homeless now.
Mate, that is weird.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Just taking so fucking long.
Oh, mate, it's not good. Get us some bog roll, it's bleeding, look.
Oh, Jesus, put it away, Neil.
I can't, it stings when it rubs on my pants.
Well, take your pants off then.
But then it'll rub on my jeans.
Neil, no matter what your old man says, you can't walk around London with your knob hanging out.
I forgot, pants is underwear. I was thinking just like
I didn't do nothing.
Jeans.
I wasn't doing anything.
Let's go out there with just your boxes on.
So she didn't see the romantic intention behind the tramp shoes?
Not immediately, but if that prick Adam had been there, it would have been different.
To be fair to him, the smell is appalling.
What happened with Rachel?
Oh, the usual. It was going quite well, then she realised I'm a massive dickhead and pulled some other bloke.
Right.
Will gets too possessive.
Shit here, isn't it?
Yeah. Shall we go?
Yeah.
No, wait! I wasn't wanking!
Oh,
my
right.
Cock's cut! My cock is cut!
So we were chucked out the club. The actual club chucked us out. Exactly 25 minutes after it started, our life as cool London clubbers was over.
So
at least they're good friends. They left when the other
All
friends
I was
got
doing
knocked
was looking
out.
At the cut on my cock. Jay was helping me out. Sorry. Jay was helping you out.
It's not how it sounds.
It sounds like you were watching Neil wank in the toilets.
I wasn't wanking, I was just rolling it around in my hands.
All right, spare us the details. Oh, fuck, what if Cardi's getting off with that bloke?
Don't cry, Si. At least you can get your trainers back.
What?
Fucking beauty, oh, that wee bastard.
Oh, brilliant. Well, how have you done that?
What?
You've only had him an hour.
Maybe he's been out.
Technically, he's always out. Right, that's it. Let's go. I've had enough. Standing sober in an alleyway, stinking of piss and wearing a tramp shoes was not what I had planned for this evening.
Out of interest, did you think it would go better or worse than this?
So the night was over, and all we wanted to do now was get back in Simon's shit car and go
damn
home.
Shoes.
Oh, fuck! Oh, fuckity!
I thought he was going to get towed, but
oh.
A boot is...
Ooh,
shit.
The same
right, how
thing,
much money have we got between us?
No, you chose to park here.
You fucking hell, Jay. Will.
Sorry, mate, I don't have any money left. Get an ink clean me out. I think you have to call your dad.
One in the morning, he's gonna go fucking mental. And I told him I was staying at Neil's.
Unlock it, Si, I'm freezing.
He loves you. I'm sure he'd rather come and get you than see you suffer.
Oh, boy.
Dad, Simon. Simon! Don't panic, nothing's wrong. Just calm down.
No, I'm not dead.
Well, if I'm dead, how could I be talking to you?
Oi! You owe me £200.
I'll call you back.
Sir, as I'm sure you're aware, private clamping is illegal. In addition to that, it is a week...
I couldn't get my fucking van out.
Look, I just called my dad and...
I couldn't give a fuck. £200, now!
I don't have it.
We don't have it!
I want £200! Can't you fucking read? Park
no smash.
Fucking park it! I missed all my fucking delivery!
Carly!
Don't call
money now!
Carly!
I'll fucking kill you unless you give me my fucking money!
Do you still
money.
Want that list?
I'm not gonna stop! Where's my money?
Don't call us!
Wait!
£200!
See you Monday!
£200! I'll fucking kill you unless you give me my fucking money!
So we had successfully reinvented ourselves, but not as the boys who go clubbing. Oh no. We were now the boys who freaked out girls.
Can you stop staring at my tits?
Apologised a lot.
I'm really sorry.
Wore tramp shoes and wanked in public toilets.
My cock is hard!
I think you've got a big problemo.
Please just shut up, Neil.
All right.
Maybe you should try saying sorry over and over.
Oh, sorry for parking like a knob.
Oh, just fuck off!
Oh boy. Okay, hopefully this time the playback is okay. It wasn't lagging too much. I think I figured out what the problem was. There was some settings that were focused too much on quality. Hopefully it doesn't destroy too much of the quality of the video, but whatever. Oh man, yeah, there's a lot of lessons to be learned this time. Again, Will started off very good. He started off great. The girl showed a little bit of interest in him. The problem with Will is whenever he gets shown some interest, he thinks that means that they're dating now. Like, anytime a girl shows the slightest bit of kindness to him, he just jumps to, okay, I guess we're going out. So they're like, no, Will, relax. Take it one step at a time. If he would have just approached her and just said something casual like, all right, well, you know, you owe me a dance or something like that. Like, something small. Like, hey, I'm trying to, like, I'm interested in dancing. I know you got your thing, but hey, you owe me a dance, right? And then just like, all right, cool, walk off. Do something else. Let her handle her business. If she wants to come back and dance with you, she'll do it. If she doesn't, she doesn't. That'll give you something to break the ice the next time you talk or something. Like, so how was the I don't want to say date. How'd you like the club? Something like that. You know, something to break the ice a little bit. But, goddamn. I keep forgetting how young these characters are supposed to be, so... at that age, you probably... Well, it depends. If you have experience, you will know, like, what to say and do. But, obviously, they don't have any experience with anything, so... They're like... ducklings being led to water. They don't know what the hell they're doing. They have to be guided, but the problem is the only person that claims to have any experience is Jay, so they're being guided by Jay. Not the best situation you want to find yourself in. This time Jay didn't really find himself in any bad situations. He keeps lying. Again, I think that stemmed from his situation with his dad and stuff like that. But yeah, he just keeps on lying and lying, and he doesn't have to. Neil, this is probably one of the few episodes where Neil actually took an L. In the past episodes, like, he always does stuff that would make you think that he's kind of stupid, but because he's always himself and doesn't really give a damn about what other people think of what he wants to do, it works for him. He'll end up getting a girl, or the situation will always work out in his favor, something like that. But this time, because of his impatience and his impulsive like actions, he kind of screwed himself this episode. And Simon, I get you have this crush on his girl. I forgot exactly how long he's had the crush on her, so I don't know like if this is something he's had damn near his entire life, or if it was just like once he started going to whatever level of school he's in. But dude has to relax, especially considering we've already seen what type of girl Carly is. Anytime Simon doesn't show her any type of attention, that's what draws her closer. So you constantly like being head over heels and waiting on her hand and foot and, you know, jumping over yourself just to be near is going to be counterintuitive. It really is. Like, badly. I'll give you guys a quick lesson. This is an experience that I had myself. Now, when I was first starting to come out of my shell, this was right around the cusp of that. So it was like before and after. Before I really came out of my shell, there was this girl that I worked with that I really liked. And I would like follow her all the time. Not from a creepy way, but like always try to work near and things like that. And like she would say stuff to like keep me interested, but at the same time, not get too serious. So it always had me kind of coming and going. I didn't know where I stood exactly. And something happened where there was a break. I believe that there was like another facility that opened up and some of the people at our facility chose to go over there. And I think she was one of them. She went over there and started working at the new facility. I was working at the old facility. So we had a bit of time apart. It was during this time apart that I started to get into my, I'm going to try to better myself mode. So I went out and got a whole new wardrobe. I started investing in colognes and accessories and things like that. Start going to the barbershop, getting my hair cut like every week, things like that. Like I started building on myself. I started focusing on like improving the way I talk and the way I carried myself, things like that. And when she came back, I already knew, like, because of people I talked to and things like that, that I should, like, back off. So treat her like a friend, but that's it. So I would, like, say hi to her, talk to her and stuff like that. But then when it was time for us to separate, I would separate. Like, there was no hesitation with it. I would just turn around and just go. And then it wasn't until I started noticing she started waiting for me. Like, I'd be at lunch and like we'd be sitting down having lunch or something like that, and she'd be like, all right, I'm gonna go back onto the floor. I'm like, all right, I'll see you later. So I'd be eating, I'd get up from the table, go to walk. She'll get up, walk back to the floor. I'll still be eating. I'll finish my food, get up, go to walk back to the floor. She's waiting at the door, and she was waiting for me. So she'll turn around and start walking with me once I like started going to the floor again. So that's something that taught me, like, there are different kinds of girls, and obviously this isn't like a generalized thing, because every girl is different for obvious reasons. But there are personality traits that everybody has. You know what an egotistical person is, you know what an attention seeking person is, you know what somebody that is an introvert, extrovert. Like all of them, even though they're different, they have qualities that are similar. That taught me that there were people out there that like the more distance you put yourself in, not too much distance, you still got to show a little bit of interest, but the more distance you kind of put between you and these particular type of people, the more interesting you come off as. A little bit of mystery is something that is interesting. It just is. So if there is somebody that you like and like you're head over heels for them, you're doing everything you can for them, and it just seems like they just aren't that into you, like they do stuff that always makes you think that there's a chance, But then whenever you try to go to the next level, they back up. What you should do is stop showing them so much attention. Sometimes people like the idea that they have someone that they can count on to help boost their, I want to say ego. It's not ego. They want someone that they feel can boost their confidence. So like if they don't feel like they're having a good day where they feel cute, or a day when they feel like they got it going on or whatever else, they'll come to you and they know, okay, this person's going to, like, if this person thinks that I look bad today, then something's really going on. And you keep giving them the attention, they're just using you to help themselves. But once you stop becoming that option and like distance yourself and start, you know, pretending like, oh, we're not pretending, actually do this. Once you start having a life that doesn't revolve around them, then that's when they start to follow you. They want to become a part of your world because now you're no longer a part of theirs. And I'm not somebody that's like, that has all the answers by no means. Like I said, this is something that works with some girls. Sometime it won't work with others. Some girls, they might be seeking attention, but if you show, like, if the girl is somebody that gets a lot of attention, like a lot of attention, this goes with guys too. If there's somebody that has a lot of attention, you show, like, you starting to distance yourself, it might not have that much of an effect because they can just replace you with somebody else that'll be, you know, worshiping the ground they walk on. But that's just something you have to accept. Like, just distance yourself. Still, like, talk to them and things like that. You know, be friendly. But don't go too far into it. Like, if you're following them and they think that you're really interested in them, then they got you. But the second you start to create some space, then they'll want to get closer to you just because they want to rekindle that thing they had where it was like, okay, well, if I'm near this person, they're going to do what I want them to do. But over time, the tables are turning, and sometimes they won't even realize the tables are turning. Then next thing you know, they'll be doing stuff that you want to do, or they'll be doing, like, they'll be interested in the stuff that you're interested in. And like, it'll be more of an even relationship than it was before. But again, it's not guaranteed. Sometimes you got to accept that it's not guaranteed. Everybody's different. Stuff doesn't work all the time. That's Devon DaVinci's lesson for today. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you hit that like button, subscribe, and share. That's the best way you can help my channel. If you have any experience with these types of people, go ahead and leave it in the comment section down below, because, you know, maybe if we have enough stories that somebody can read through and they can, like, triangulate what all the common things in these stories are and just, like, focus on that. And then maybe it'll help them in their situation. So be sure to let people know what your situation and story is, and, you know, try to help the next person out. I'm going to give you guys the deuces. I look forward to seeing you guys in the future video. Next Inbetweeners episode will be on Thursday. And that's pretty much it. I'm going to give you the deuces, and I'm signing out. Deuces.